Well, hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from Tutvid.com. Welcome into this Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial where today I want to talk about what might be the most important thing for you to know if you do any kind of animating in Premiere Pro, whether it's complex or simple transitions or just animating text and title, just stuff in general, animating anything in Premiere Pro. This is a must-know tip. It has to do with what I like to call deep easing and how you can really take advantage of easing to get some amazing animations that, quite frankly, look like they come out of After Effects and not Premiere Pro. So if you do a lot of work in Premiere Pro, I think you're going to love this. It's going to be kind of a quick tip. Hey, if you do enjoy this video, though, make sure you subscribe to this channel and turn those notifications on so you never miss another video editing, After Effects, Premiere Pro, you name it, tutorial from Tutvid, well, the Tutvid channel, I should say, here on YouTube. And with that out of the way, guys, let's jump into Premiere right now and check this thing out. All right, here we are. And what I've got is a text title over this video. And the first thing I'm going to do is set it to the blend mode of color dodge, which is going to give it kind of some crazy color. Maybe that's a little bit too much. I'll reduce the opacity to like 90% and be done with the opacity. You can see it's just a simple text object. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go to effects panel here and look for an effect called transform. Here it is down here under distort. I'm going to drag that. I can drop it right on the clip. I can drop an effect controls. Doesn't make a difference. Here's what makes a difference. Up here under transform, we're going to scale this puppy. So we're gonna scale it to like 100. We're going to get it to 100% here. So I'm going to tick the toggle animation stopwatch there to drop a keyframe. And then I'm going to move all the way back to the beginning, and I'm going to set scale to 0%. So what did we just do? Well, we created a very simple but very clunky, static-looking animation that, let's be honest, it looks kind of like crap. So here's how we change that and make it not so crappy. I'm going to select both of these keyframes. I'm going to right-click. And I'm going to choose Auto Bezier just to apply a little bit of easing to them. I also want to give this a little blur. This, by the way, is why I use the transform effect instead of just animating the normal scale, because I can uncheck Use Composition Shutter Speed, which is what the long text is here, and change the shutter angle to 360 degrees. By the way, I covered this effect in a recent tutorial I did on 5 tips and tricks on animating in Premiere, but it was so good, and I love it so much, I just had to do a separate tutorial on it. After we've done that, we're going to have a little bit of blur on our text. You can see now we got some blur happening in there, and the faster the text goes, like the shorter we, or the less time we give the animation, the more craziness we're going to have in terms of that blur. But that's not enough. If I hit this little arrow over here, I will spin down my scaling options, and to really take full advantage, you want to make sure you select the playhead and hit your plus button so you can zoom in on this. And then select any keyframe here, and we're going to give this a little bit of like a zoom bump effect. So if I grab this handle and push it up, what's going to happen is the text is actually going to scale up past where we need it to go and then retract back into place. We haven't added any keyframes. That's just the effect. Pretty cool. So that has to do with animating the actual scaling effect. Down here, this velocitation bit, this is our easing down here. So we can change this. We can say, look, go really slowly at the beginning and then speed up toward the end, or vice versa. We could say, you know what, start really fast, and then we kind of want you to chill out here toward the end. We want you to really slow down. But I really don't want this handle down here to go anything less than flat, maybe a very little bit, but I want this handle up here to be kind of close to flat. If it's pointing downward, it means that we're scaling down below where we started, which we're starting at zero, so it probably doesn't make too much of a difference here, but let's check to see what this looks like. Zooms way up and bounces into place. Look at that effect. So that's really cool, and we can change the way this whole thing looks by just changing our easing here. We could make it start out really slowly and snap into place right at the end. Let's just make sure we're still getting a good bounce, and watch what this looks like now. It comes up slowly and snaps into place much faster. Boom, just like that. Really, really cool stuff. So that's what this tutorial is about. Use those deep easing features. They are really amazing. And it's not just with scaling. Scaling is just a great one to show because not only can you play with the easing, but you can also play with the scale and have it kind of bump in and settle into its final resting place. But position, all these different animatable parameters with these different effects, you can jump in and fine-tune the easing exactly as you like it. And the more you play with the easing, it doesn't take that long, and it starts to feel like second nature. And boy, it's a good feeling, second nature, if I've ever felt a nice feeling, second nature. It makes you feel like you can actually get a decent animation out of Premiere Pro, and that's one of the things that I love so much about it. So for animating here in Premiere Pro and using this kind of deep easing effect to actually get a really nice animation in Premiere Pro, guys, for this one, that's it. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodson, Tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.